You seem to have undergone quite a profound conversion in Mexico, Mr. Mandus.
You could not have seen it yourself and not, Professor. As we disembarked, even through my fever, I saw the detritus of this so-called progress. I saw starvation and disease, rot and destruction polluting the waters of the Empire. We are ruiners, you and I, and all of us, and we make the world unclean.
And you took it upon yourself to act as Redeemer.
Professor, I would not be so presumptuous. I am merely a conduit. I am constructing an architecture to wrestle our damnation to the ground and smother it with steam.
He's here! He's here! I said you'd come.
Ahead, the trickle to still waters. I dragged myself deeper into the temple, downward ever, towards a wind that held the voices of my children, beckoning me to set them free.
Thank you.
fled to London, and you set me upon a mantelpiece, and then you went into the house and gathered the servants and reset you and I on recrafting them, and then you went into the garden and buried those tiny shattered skulls alone. Children, Mandus, to spare them the world you have created for us all. They feel no pain. The process is completely humane.
Humane, Professor? That we judge the acceptable level of suffering by the human condition?
Ask the beggar, Professor.
Ask the orphan. Ask the whore. Ask the starving, Professor. The weak, the sick, the filthy. Ask them to define your humane.
Mandus. Set them free. Set them all free. I live. I breathe again. I rise. I will rise to bleach the sky and still the water. I will spin the world wheel and set the future upon the path to redemption.
Where are my children? You promised me my children.
My time is come. More pig. More pig.
Boys. Boys. I'm so sorry.